With that, what are the good and bad side of Twitch drops? For this, I'm talking purely from a Last Day on Earth perspective. There are a bunch of other games that have Twitch drops and have been covered in depth by a number of really good videos, two of my personal favorites right on the screen right now, which I highly recommend you check out, but this video is going to be purely about the Last Day on Earth experience. Also, full disclaimer, I'm not making this video to attack anyone, not Kafir, the developers, not LDOE drop streamers, or viewers, for that matter. This video is purely made to express my own personal thoughts and opinions about this topic. And with that out of the way, let's proceed. So first off, how do drops work in Last Day on Earth? They work a little differently than most other games. First, you'll need to watch a partner streamer's stream in order to even get drops, and they'll need to have drops activated. Once every 30 minutes, a random viewer can receive a drop. It's all RNG, random number generator for non-LDOE players, or luck-based if you'll get a drop and luck-based on what you'll get. About 1 in 10 viewers will receive a drop, and it scales up from there. As of recently, using sites like MultiTwitch no longer work. You can only watch one stream for a chance to earn rewards, and I'm not sure if the volume needs to be unmuted or the stream can't be in an external tab or something like that, but keep that in mind. So let's start out with the good side of Twitch drops. I'm trying to take a more nuanced viewpoint from the traditional statements of Twitch drops equals good or Twitch drops equals bad. Before Twitch drops became a thing in Last Day on Earth on a streaming platform was at probably one of the lower points. The highest view count on the pre-drop streams was about 20, and after Twitch drops became a thing, about 200, falling to 100 after the months slowed down. In that time, I remember how amazing it was to go and watch streams. The market wasn't way too oversaturated, there was the perfect balance between viewers and streamers alike, and now that it's spiked with the recent endgame content, viewers and streamers alike are on the rise, which has brought more and more things in the form of in-game items accessible through drops, including some items that can only be obtained through drops. We'll talk about that a little bit later. And with this most recent update bringing a new light on LDOE Twitch drops, the LDOE Twitch community has never been stronger. More and more people are watching streams in order to get these in-game items. And I'm seeing more and more people expressed to a wider audience they normally wouldn't see. Because of Twitch drops, a player might try and visit a streamer they may or may not have seen before in order to win something good. So, what's in the bad? Let's start with the topic of putting exclusive items behind a chance-on-chance system. The game intentionally subjects players to watch someone and something they may or may not be interested in. To answer the question, I'm probably going to say in the comments, but ZD, you don't have to watch streams. Take note that before Last Day on Earth added these exclusive items to drops, loot crate versions were available in the in-game shop. So if a player wanted them badly enough, they could just go to the shop directly. Now that exclusive items have been placed behind a wall that requires someone to watch someone or something, that's no longer an option. To highlight the differentiation between the past situation and the current situation, there was not a requirement, per se, to watch streams to unlock every item in the game. You play the game and get the rewards. Simple enough. But now, if you want to get the items, it's a mandatory requirement that you must watch a stream or you cannot get the item. Lastly, and this point's quite minuscule to some of the other points I've made, and only has to do with some of the contents about the drops in Last Day on Earth, and that point being Last Day on Earth giving drops with patterns from limited seasons really depreciates and devalues some of these formerly specific rare cosmetics. Now I know you guys are gonna go at it in the comments, so please hear me out. For example, the other day I saw the image of someone who unlocked the Season 4 Ice Cream Truck skin. Yes, the Ice Cream Truck skin. The one from that really strange point system where only the top 5% of players were supposed to have. To someone who spent money trying to get it back during Season 4, that's not really something you want to hear. Because few players could get it, it makes that skin feel rare, that only 5% of the world actually had it. I mean, assuming the system is true. But now, anyone can get it just by watching a stream. If you asked any Last Day on Earth player what the rarest item was 2 years ago, they'd say the Chinese Armor. The Chinese Armor was a one-time Chinese New Year event in which a player could obtain a set of armor, but the next year the armor appeared in a pack at the shop, and pass rewards later on in the season pass. Ask any Last Day on Earth player today, and while they still may agree that the armor is semi-rare, it's nowhere near as exclusive as it once was, limited to that one event during that one time. The same is true for that ice cream truck. it should be rare for those very few who empty their wallets, but because anyone can get it now, it's not so rare. The main takeaway I want to come from this video is to look at Last Dinner with Twitch Drops in a more unclear light. It's not the greatest gift since EATV, but nor is it something that's going to burn Last Day on Earth to the ground. Overall, I do like the idea of Twitch Drops, but I think there's a way they could have implemented it differently, per se. I'm really interested to see how things play out from here, hopeful in the fact that Last Day on Earth will eventually find the right, perfect footing, but again, I don't know. To reiterate, my point here isn't to attack anyone, devs, drop streamers, viewers, etc., but solely to voice an opinion on the topic. If you made it this far, please let me know your thoughts down below. Quite interested to read the comments on this video. Anyways, this has been a really interesting video to make. Hope you've enjoyed it. Subscribe. Only 13% of people who watch these videos actually are, so if you're not, do it. ZD out.